blessed it is to be in the house of the Holy Spirit. I feel it every week, and it's good to be with brothers and sisters that have the joy of the Lord, and I just wanted to say that.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let us say a quick word of prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for your Holy Spirit being here with us. You be with to us, God. Thank you for the name, God, and how they blessed us today. Lord, you're just doing so many good things. Thank you for the unity we have in this church. Lord, may your spirit help somebody through your word. Help your servant to decrease, and may you increase. This we pray in Jesus' name, and everyone said amen.
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 Theme for today is He's My Refuge. He's My Refuge. And I have to ask a question. I think it was 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, we asked, or the Holy Spirit asked, for everybody to pick one psalm and read that psalm for a week. One chapter. How many of you have been doing okay with that? I'll raise it. I'll just ask the question like that. Amen. That's a good thing. Now, think about it now. One chapter probably takes about 2 minutes, right? Besides sleep, we all have about 16 hours a day. And, you know, think about that. We want to give God, and that's spiritual nourishment, you know? We think of all that we do for our bodies. You know, we stay in the mirror, make sure we get it right. Some of us, man, we home doing push-ups, going to the gym. Our spirit needs that as well. Amen. So we want to just do things in unison. So reading a psalm, one chapter for the week is going to bless you. And how we've been doing with giving up something on Tuesdays and Thursdays? How many of y'all been working at that? Amen. Hallelujah. Now we're going to add one more thing to the equation. This one's deep. All right. At least, you can pick your days at least 3 times a week. Some of y'all are already doing this. You're going to close your door and get quiet with God. Okay? I'm talking about away from everybody. Nobody but you behind the door if you're just giving 15 minutes. All right? So what are we doing? We're denying the flesh, feeding the spirit, and getting in his presence. Oh, man, you're going to be ready for the devil when you keep that going. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He is my refuge. And I love this Psalm of David, and that's what we're going to do today. My brothers and sisters, we are going to look at a few psalms. And what we're going to remind ourselves is that he is our refuge. But I think some of us get confused about refuge because we want to get out of stuff. And sometimes your refuge is not pretty, but you're safe. He uses these two words in verse 1. It says, God is our refuge. And what's the other word he uses? And our strength. And when we talk about the word refuge, I'm going to give you some of the definitions. It's a shelter. It's rest. It's hope. And a place of trust. Hallelujah. So when we're talking about God being your refuge, you can see now things have changed. Right? He's our shelter. He's going to provide. He's a rest stop. He's where that shelter is where we get hope. And it's a place where we renew ourselves in trusting him. Hallelujah. I thank him today that he's my refuge. I had a pastor about 3 years ago come to me. And this man was going through quite a bit. Him and his wife were separated. He lost his ministry. And his wife was living with someone who was, let's just say, not a good influence on the children. Those children were going through. this man walked in on his five-year-old doing something that you don't see too many adults do. When I tell you the devil was attacking this man on all sides, and now, you know, there was attorneys involved, and, you know, and so when you talk about his war, the war wasn't going to end anytime soon, okay? Some of the stuff that we're battling right now might not end in the near future. But what I told him was, I said, I've been where you are. I've been in those storms where you're separated in the house, and it's crazy. But what the Holy Spirit taught me was how to find those rest stops.
Yes.
How to find those places where you could hide and be quiet and, yes, and protect it to where your mind has a chance to settle down. I said, what you gotta do is, because he was constantly, you know, he was just out there all the time. And I said, you gotta find some rest stops. You gotta find, in other words, some refuge. And some of us, in the midst of what we are battling, God wants to provide refuge for us. He wants to provide that shelter where we can get that hope, get our hope renewed, and establish that place of trust. I thank God for the rest stops. Whenever I've been going through some serious battles, the Lord has helped me to get in places where I can renew my mind.
Yes.
That's why when you get up in the morning, you want to have some strategy to feed your spirit man, because the Spirit will guide you to that refuge where you will have that shelter and that rest. See, sometimes God don't answer our problems and circumstances right away. He has a plan. I mean, look at your neighbor and say, he has a plan.
He has a plan.
Sometimes he's got to perfect his plan. But in the meantime, the devil's trying to pound on your mind, and you need to find a place of refuge. Hallelujah. And the next word he uses here is the word strength. The word strength now represents security. Hallelujah. And what I like now, this word is going to sound strange to you, but it represents the word strong. You know, back in the day, I had a friend of mine whose father had a furniture store over in Point Pleasant, and he used to buy antique furniture. Y'all know them old hutches, they weigh. And I used to, I made good extra money on the side. He would call me up, but he trusted me. Because even though there are people who might be able to bench more than me, I was what you call strong in the fact that I could carry weight a long way. You know, when my son was going through the NFL combines, they didn't care if you could bench 700 pounds one time. They wanted to make sure you could bench 225 about 20 times. See, because it ain't about strength, it's about being strong. It's about having endurance. You know, one time, I need to just say this, one time, my buddy's back went out. So he had to call in another guy. This guy was huge. Y'all see Jim, you about Jim size. You know, and we had to carry this hutch. That was a compliment, Jim. Kenny, I could have used a few people. I could use Kyle. We got some serious brothers in here. Point being now, we're carrying this hutch from the second floor, this old antique hutch. And, you know, I got underneath that thing. Because don't let me fool you now. Back in the day, I was all right. I'm still all right. But anyhow, we're carrying this hutch down the stairs, and we get it almost to the truck. And I said, how you doing? He said, you want to take a rest? I said, yeah, we can take a rest. But it blessed my soul that he needed to take a rest. Y'all not here. Now, me and him got under and started benching. He probably lived more than me, but when it came to endurance, I was right there. See, when he's saying I'm your refuge and I'm your strength, I'm going to help you endure. You're not just going to be strong today. You're going to stand up to that devil every day. Hallelujah. And then he says now he's a present help. A present help. And what I like the definition here, it means to come forth, to appear. See, out of nowhere, when you least expect it, God will show up and come forth and give you that strength. Hallelujah. The problem now with most of us and most people when it comes to the manifestation of God, or if I use the term spiritual intervention, most people are really not interested in the move of God until they get in a situation where they need refuge. See, most of us, you have to be careful because you're waiting until you, God got to bring you out of something to get in his face. See, he's my refuge every day. I don't wait until something happens to get in his presence. I get in his presence all the time. He's my refuge just getting me up in the morning. I rely on him each and every second of the day. And see, a lot of us, you know, you have folks out in here in the world right now, if you walk in their house and say, I want the Spirit of God to come in the house right now. Look at you like, man, what is wrong with this guy? But let those same people now be dying again. Let them same people be desperate for something. They will let you call on your God, his God, and everybody else's God. See, everybody, you know, we're not afraid of a manifestation when it fits us. When it fits what we want. When it fits what we need. Okay, folks, that's what I'm telling you right now. In just a witnessing technique for you, people will always be open to prayer. They may not want to hear about Jesus, but let them get in a situation. They'll let you pray for them. Yeah. Right? Because when people need something, when they need refuge, they'll pay. Call on whoever. Yes. So please, let's be careful now. Some of y'all are waiting until God got to move out of the way. You getting yourself in a situation to where now, okay, God, oh Lord, I need you. No, let's not wait. He's my refuge right now. Hallelujah. So we're going to look at a few psalms here and look at a few situations. Turn to Psalm 9, if you will. We're going to look at a few situations that bring out this word refuge. And Psalms 9, verse 9, is going to set the tone for why we need refuge. We're not putting it up on the screen. Amen? I want to hear those papers. When you have it, say amen. Amen. Look what it says. I'm reading from the... Oh, well, actually, this will be the King James. The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in the times of trouble. And those who know your name put their trust in you. For you, O Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you. Look at that word now, oppressed. When we talk about the need of refuge, we are talking about those of us who are being oppressed. Look at the definition now. Lassitude of body, which means physical or mental weariness. So I just want to lay that out there right now. When we talk about the need for refuge, we are talking about needing strength because we are physically and mentally weary. Hallelujah. He's my refuge. And he's your refuge. So we just wanted to set the tone. I want to read that scripture one more time. The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed. A stronghold in the times of trouble. And those who know your name put their trust in you. For you, O Lord, have not forsaken those now who what? Seek you. All right? That's what I'm trying to tell you. Hallelujah. We give God praise. Let the church say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We just let the devil pay for that, right? Because he don't like to hear hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, now, turn now to Psalm 59. Okay. Now we're going to start looking at forms of refuge. Sean, can you put that first picture up there? Y'all see slaves?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Look at that verse 15. It says, but I will sing of your strength. I will sing aloud of your steadfast love in the morning. For you have been to me a fortress and a refuge in the day of my distress. O my strength, I will sing praises to you. For you, O God, are my fortress, the God who shows me steadfast love. The reason why I'm showing you this picture of these slaves is because back in the day, they would, and some of you probably know this, but they would use praise songs and they would hide codes in the songs and they would be used for escape routes. So what I'm trying to tell you now, we talk about it a lot, and I think I don't clarify it enough when we talk about praising him through what you're going through. Because some of you, if things get that bad, you will really get mad at God sometimes. And sometimes you won't acknowledge him. You'll pout in his presence. Or you'll start to complain. These things are definitely no-nos in the spirit world. And the reason why we praise him is because we're still acknowledging, I trust you. You're still my shelter. My hope is in you. Because there's times now when that refuge and how God is keeping us and how he's protecting us, it doesn't feel good. Sometimes refuge does not feel good. Hallelujah. And where these slaves during that time, that was a difficult period. But they learned how to find refuge in their praising him. A lot of these old gospel hymns that we sing were birthed back then. I'm telling you, if you could learn to praise God in the midst of what you're going through, God will trigger a code in your spirit.
Thank
and
you.
The devil won't be able to do anything with you.
Thank you.
When you talk about escape routes now, their lives were on the line. They had those who specialized in tracking down slaves. But when the song was birthed through what they were going through, that song became refuge. That song gave them hope. But in this case, that song was an escape from the bondage. I found that in my difficult moments, praising God and acknowledging that, you know what, Lord, this doesn't feel good. I don't like it, but you're still God. And I want the devil to know that I have not renounced who you are in my life. When you do that now, you're creating refuge. Because the scripture says now that he abides in the praises of his people. So whenever you praise God, he makes his abode with you. Hallelujah. So here we see a classic example now of the fact that part of our refuge must be praise. Because if it's murmuring and it's complaining and it's I don't like this, then what you're doing is the spirit is going to back off hallelujah, the devil's going to get in you.